Hey, this is Jim Bergman on behalf of Sauerman. Today I want to talk a little bit about exhaust gas recirculation. One of the most common problems that we get is everybody trying to fix everything at the appliance. And so I wanted to show you a little symptom that we see quite a bit that people don't often pay attention to that's a great use for your combustion analyzer. So right now I have this set up with a furnace intake pipe. Come over here so you can take a look at what I'm looking at here. I have the combustion analyzer in the intake pipe. So we're reading the fresh air coming in. I have the door on the bottom of the furnace. So we're drawing in fresh air from outside. And that oxygen level in the furnace should be at 20.9%. So let's come over here and let's take a peek at this for just a minute. And you can see that as the furnace is starting up here, that oxygen level is actually starting to drop down below 20.9% oxygen. And this is indicating that we have flue gas that's actually recirculating on the appliance, meaning that instead of getting exhausted all the way outside, that it's coming back into the furnace. And if this gets high enough, we'll actually start to see the CO start to rise on here. And this is a huge problem because a lot of technicians would see a CO problem on the furnace, and they might have the door off the furnace, and they might not even see this problem because without the door on, we really don't know how the appliance is operating. So when you do your final combustion analysis, A, always have the door on. But B, also drill a hole in your intake pipe and sample your incoming air and make sure that incoming air has 20.9% oxygen, because if it's lower than that, you could have a pretty serious problem. So let's take another peek here. We're still holding about that 20.5%. So let's go outside and let's see if there's any obstructions to this flue pipe. So this is an example of why we have combustion problems. And if you look here, if we get far enough inside the bushes, we can actually see there's a furnace exhaust vent right here. And that furnace exhaust vent, a couple things I want to point out here. There could be a pathway back for CO back into the house. We don't know exactly what's behind this, so we need to take a close look at that. But this siding looks like it was done after the furnace vent was put in. And this is trying to exhaust out here. This is exhaust hitting all these bushes and things, that air circulating back into the intake cone. So that's what's causing the low level of oxygen inside the furnace. Now, what we got to be careful of is that not only do we have now a source of potential CO, so we have a source, we're restricting the oxygen down to the furnace, but we also have a pathway, or potentially a pathway back into the house. So you always got to pay close attention when you're doing a combustion analysis. Again, put the door on the furnace if it's sealed combustion to make sure that we're pulling the air from outside and we don't have exhaust gas recirculation and the furnace is operating and not producing excessive amounts of CO. And then again, always keep an eye open for potential pathways back into the structure.